Let's talk to Dallas on the Turnpike. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Hi, Dallas.
Hey, you guys. How you doing today? Hey, Judy, big fan of yours. You know that?
Thank you.
Real fan. When you're out in the supermarket and you have your daughter with you by any chance, how do you feel when you see a woman with a veil over her face?
I have two daughters who cover their hair with either wigs or scarves when they're in public. So I absolutely understand that concept. It's a religious concept, so it's a little difficult for me to get on, you know, explain it on the air, but I absolutely understand the concept of a married woman covering her hair. So, because my daughters do it.
All right, that's understandable, but when you're covering your whole face and everything like that, with the movement where women have become,
I am a huge supporter of traditional woman's roles, much more so than I am of the modern woman's role. So if a woman's religion calls for her to cover her face for modesty, I understand it. I'm sorry. I know that you were thinking you're going to trip me up with that, but I understand that. And, you know, that's why my daughters don't wear pants, because they're extremely modest. And some religious people, those are the tenets of their religion. And it's because we respect the roles of the traditional woman.
Whoa, that's scary.
I know. Traditionalism.
But a lot of women have to. Now, for example, a woman that comes out against that in the Middle East countries, where you're under attack if you should do that.
Yeah, no. Of course. I wouldn't. I pray that no woman ever gets killed for being raped the way they do, what do you call those Islamic...
Oh, some mercy killings or...
I can't remember what it is.
Honor killings?
If you're raped, you get honor killings. Those things, you know, of course.
Judy, where do you draw the difference between, and how do you know?
I don't... Nobody knows. You see, here's the thing. If you're a religious person, these things come from religion. If you're a religious person, you don't know. You just have to do what your soul and your heart and your faith tells you to do. Nobody knows the truth. So if you lay down your head at night and know for a fact that anybody who's religious and covers their hair and covers their face and covers whatever is wrong, you're lying to yourself, because I don't know and you don't really know.
Okay, for a law enforcement agent, when he has stopped a vehicle and he needs to identify the person in the vehicle, where do you draw the line with that?
It's very difficult. I mean, I believe that if you want to be a cop and you want to wear a beard, you shouldn't be able to be a cop.
All right, thank Dallas. We got to run up against traffic, but thanks for the call. I guess he's saying if they're looking for a suspect and three of the women in the car, their faces covered.
By the way, I've been a proponent of profiling for many years. I think if you look dark and scary in an airport, you're the people who should be questioned.
But a woman just robbed a bank and there's a description, but all three women are now wearing facial veils.
I understand that. But what are you going to do?
I don't know how we got here. It's 12:19. Here's fast traffic.